Welcome to Radio Frequency and Microwave Laboratory. This is Prashant, Laboratory Assistant, RGKT, Vasara.
Now, operational procedure. Switching on this power supply and meter selector power. Power on the meter selector. First, we have to say gun supply consists of 16x2 dot matrix display. Here we can observe voltages, currents drawn by gun diode and which type of wave we are utilizing. When it is in continuous mode, we are not going to use pin modulator. So pin modulator is in off condition. Whenever we are pressing mode select button, it shifts to the internal. Whenever it is in internal mode, pin bias is activated with 0 to 10 volts peak to peak square. And we have another two modes, that is audio signal mode and PC data. In audio signal mode, by giving an external input to the audio input, we are going to generate a signal and transmit it to end of the load. When it is in PC mode, data is according to the PC data, pin bias is modulated. And we have to set it into the internal mode. When we are doing experiment, we have to set it into the internal mode. And modulation frequency and pin bias are set into the mid positions. And now we are going to vary gun bias. While we are varying gun bias, we have to note down voltages and currents. Voltage and currents are linearly increases. After reaching peak point, it decreases and again it starts increasing. By varying gun bias voltage, you can observe a square wave on CR. To maximize that reading, by using micrometer, adjust the length of micrometer, we are going to get a square. It is a very nice square wave, and by adjusting the length, you will get a good one. Up to clear sine wave observed on CRO screen, we have to set the micrometer wavelength. After getting clear square wave, we have to Now you can observe a square wave on CRO screen. Now we have to take readings of Now coming to the direct method. In this direct method, we are going to find out frequency of a given signal. By using frequency meter, we are going to find the frequency. By tuning this frequency meter, at one position, we can see dip on CRO screen. Slowly. So whenever dip is occurred on CRO screen, that is our frequency. So we can observe a red vertical line on top of the frequency meter, and internally it consists of two copper lines. So in between the two copper lines we have a numerical numbers. This red line is matches with that numerical numbers. We have to take that as our reading. Now it is 11.075 is our frequency. After taking the reading of this frequency, we have to detune the frequency meter again. Then we will get maximum output at CRO screen. Now note down the frequency 11.075. And in this process, we are not going to find wavelength of the signal. To find out that wavelength of the signal, we are shifting to slotted line method. In slotted line method, we are going to use slotted line section, crystal detector, and we are going to insert this crystal detector into the slotted line section, and by moving towards the left, we are going to take main scale reading, vernier scale reading into least count format. So whenever we are connecting here, we will get a square wave over here. So what we did in Klystron, same we have to repeat here. By connecting, by moving towards the left direction, we will get maximas and minimas. From there, successive maximas or successive minimas we are going to take as D1 and D2 centimeters. From there, we have to find out guide wavelength. Guide wavelength is equal to 2 into D2 minus D1. After finding the guided wavelength, we have to find frequency. So frequency is C by lambda naught, where C is intensity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. We have to substitute those values here and we will get frequency. After taking the frequency, we are going to compare with direct method to the indirect method. If any frequency error is occurred, we have to check it out and note down the values. After the completion of experiment, we have to remove crystal detector and detune the frequency meter initial condition, and by mod frequency and pin bias, we are going to reduce to the minima position, and gun bias also to the minima position and power of the device.
Thanking you.